So we come to the most important question. What is program analysis? Program analysis involves discovering information about a given program, representing the dynamic behavior of the program. Most often obtained without executing the program. There are dynamic analyses as well, but when we talk about program analysis, almost always we talk about static analysis. In particular, this course is going to restrict itself to static analysis. An important property of the information that we discover is that it must represent all execution instances of the program. And it is useful because we can perform code optimization for improving time, space, energy, or power efficiency. We can use it for compilation for special architectures such as multi-core. We can use the information so discovered for verification and validation. For example, we may want to give guarantees such as the program will never divide a number by zero, never dereference a null pointer, it will close all open files and all open socket connections, it will not allow buffer overflow security violation. It can also be used for software engineering, for maintenance of programs, for bug fixes, for enhancements, for code migration. It can also be used for understanding the program. So the important requirements of static analysis are soundness, precision, efficiency, and scalability. Soundness and precision are described more formally later in this module, but we will touch upon them. Soundness essentially says that the result that we are getting is correct. However, this notion of correctness is slightly more involved than we might assume. The reason is that static analysis results are inexact. Static analysis predicts runtime behavior of the program, but it is undecidable. By undecidability, we mean that there cannot exist an algorithm that can compute exact result for every program. And the possible reasons of undecidability are many. Values of variables are not known at compile time. Branch outcomes are not known at compile time. There are infinitely many paths in the presence of loop or recursion. There are infinitely many possible values of variables. And then even if some analysis is decidable, sometimes there are some features which are hard to analyze at compile time because they depend on the runtime information, such as eval construct in JavaScript, aliasing of array indices, effects of libraries, etc. So the summary is that static analysis predictions may not match the actual runtime behavior. Now, is this an error? So the answer is yes, but there are different kinds of errors. Some predictions may be erroneous because the predicted behavior does not match. There is a mismatch between runtime behavior and predicted behavior. But the important thing is some of these errors may be harmless, whereas some may be harmful. Some of these errors may also be unavoidable, for example, because of undecidability. So the most important question that we need to ask ourselves is, how do we characterize, detect, and minimize these errors? So let's take some examples of harmless and harmful errors. By error, we mean a guess leading to an action does not match the actual reality. If, for example, we're looking at security check at the airport, frisking a person more than others on mere suspicion is harmless from the viewpoint of security. But not frisking a person much even after suspicion is a harmless error. Both of these may be errors, but the first error is acceptable, it's harmless. The second error could create a problem, so it could be harmful. Okay? When we are doing weather prediction during rainy season, a doubtful prediction, we're not certain whether we will have heavy to very heavy rains, but still predicting it is harmless because then people can take precautions. However, because we are doubtful and we do not predict heavy to very heavy rains, that may be harmful because then people may not take adequate precautions. For medical diagnostics, subjecting a person to further investigations, assuming that the investigations are free of side effects, in general, it is harmless. However, if we avoid further investigations even after some suspicion, it could be harmful. On the other hand, for establishing justice in criminal courts, starting with an assumption that the accused is innocent is harmless. It may be erroneous. The accused may not be innocent, but at least we know that an innocent person will not be punished. Starting with the assumption that the accused is guilty could be harmful, because eventually if we discover the accused is not guilty, we would have created trouble for that particular person. So, we have errors in static analysis that are unavoidable. Some of these errors are harmless errors, and harmless errors can be tolerated but should be minimized. This deals with precision of static analysis. Harmful errors must be avoided, and this deals with soundness. Meaning, a sound static analysis must avoid harmful errors, and a precise static analysis may allow harm. So a sound analysis may have harmful errors, cannot have harmful errors, but it may have harmless errors, but it will also be precise if harmless errors can be minimized. The final requirements are efficiency and scalability. Scalability says how large inputs can be handled, what is the large size of inputs that can be handled. Efficiency is how well are resources used, how quickly are we able to arrive at the solution. Example is a strike rate of a batter in cricket is an example of efficiency, whereas total runs scored by a batter in the cricket is an example of scalability. Scalability and efficiency are orthogonal. Everything that is efficient need not be scalable. Everything that is scalable need not be efficient. And I leave you here with some examples without explaining, where we have combinations of scalability and efficiency and sorting examples, which are scalable, efficient, scalable, inefficient, non-scalable but efficient, and non-scalable and inefficient.